JRA501, I'm in Fukushima Diary. This is an article called Fukushima AIDS, posted by Mochizuki on November 5th, 2011. In Chernobyl, radioactive fallout destroyed children's immune system. That was called Chernobyl AIDS and caused catastrophic damage for the people living there. Now, a very similar disease is starting from Fukushima. It's starting to be called Fukushima AIDS. The analysis of remote decades-old data from the southern Ural area contaminated by radioactive accidents in the 1950s and 60s indicates that low-dose irradiation in utero, which was similar to that from Chernobyl, may cause impairment of neuroendocrine and neurohumoral regulation. Using those data, researchers reported vertebral osteochondrosis, osteoarthritic deformities of the extremities, atrophic gastritis, and other problems in the exposed population. An important finding to date is that for every case of thyroid cancer, there are about 1,000 cases of other kinds of thyroid gland pathology. In Belarus alone, experts estimate that up to 1.5 million people are at risk of thyroid disease. From the data collected from many different areas by many independent researchers, the spectrum and scale of endocrine pathology associated with radioactive contamination are far greater than had been suspected. It is now clear that multiple endocrine illnesses caused by Chernobyl have adversely affected millions of people. Immune system diseases. One result of many studies conducted during the last few years in Ukraine, Belarus, and Russia is the clear finding that Chernobyl radiation suppresses immunity, a person's or organism's natural protective system against infection and most diseases. The lymphatic system, the bone marrow, thymus, spleen, lymph nodes, and Peyer's patches has been impacted by both large and small doses of ionizing radiation from the Chernobyl fallout. As a result, the quantity and activity of various groups of lymphocytes and thus the production of antibodies, including various immunoglobulins, stem cells, and thrombocytes, are altered. The ultimate consequences of destruction of the immune system is immunodeficiency, and an increase in the frequency and seriousness of acute and chronic diseases and infections, as is widely observed in the Chernobyl irradiated territories. The suppression of immunity as a result of this radioactive contamination is known as Chernobyl AIDS. On the basis of review of some 150 scientific publications, the conclusion is that depression of the thymus function plays the leading role in post-radiation pathology of the immune system. Some examples of adverse effects of Chernobyl contamination on the immune system, as well as data showing the scale of damage to health of the different populations, are described in what follows. I'm not going to go into all that. The point is that Chernobyl AIDS is now, that name has now been already coined for Fukushima AIDS because of so many children that are coming up sick, very, very sick. So, I just wanted to put that out there. There's more information in here that I will bring up. There's actually, I don't know, it's over 100 and some pages long, so. But this one was connected directly to the Fukushima Diary. Interesting. Alrighty. As always, God bless.